Hey yogis, welcome to today's heart chakra yoga practice. Today's practice is going to be focused on opening up our chest and our shoulders through yin yoga postures. Yin is a little bit different than the other yoga practices that we've done before because yin will be holding these postures for about 2 to 3 minutes. And instead of going through a flow and kind of building up heat that way, we're going to be staying in these still postures and kind of face these walls in our mind. And we're going to breathe through them and just create a safe space for ourselves. And anything that comes up today, you may want to pause this and grab a journal so you can jot it down. But yeah, any thoughts that come to your head, just send them compassion and love, because that's what the heart chakra is all about. So let's go ahead and get started in a child's pose. Let's do wide-legged child's pose. And we're going to just lower our chest down and third eye down to the mat and allow our arms to extend. And you can begin settling into your body and just breathing into any spaces that feel tight. But as always during your yoga practice, if you feel any pain, definitely back out of the posture slowly and find something that works best for you. Amazing. Slowly push into your hands to gently find your way back up and transitions in yin practice are just as equally important as the pose themselves. So we're going to come onto our knees and just find a slight back bend, allowing our to open, might pedal into your wrists, and just slowly pedaling and slowly starting to lift your gaze upwards. Once you've settled in, you can, whatever feels better for you, you can keep your hands like this, or you can twist your arms around so your fingertips are pointing towards your toes. And slowly open your heart, lift up. Together, we're going to come forward into a child's pose. Third eye touches the mat. This time, hands come behind us.
slowly begin to wiggle your fingers, pushing into your knees and using the palms of your hand to come forward into tabletop, making sure our knees are underneath our hips and our wrists are underneath our shoulders. We'll take a few cat-cows, so bending our elbows, lifting up as we inhale. Exhale, arching the back, releasing the back of the neck. Inhale, press into the hands as we bend, coming forward. Look up. Exhale, arching the spine, tucking the tailbone, relaxing the back of the neck. Inhale, forward. Exhale, back. Inhale, forward. And exhale, back. One more together. Let's inhale, bend as we push into our hands. Exhale. Start moving in circles, bringing your seat to your feet. Let's go the opposite direction, linking our movement with the breath. When you come forward again, let's pause. I'll take our right hand lifted up to the ceiling and exhale, bringing our hand underneath our left arm as we thread forward. You might find some nice stretch by leaning back. You can also take your left hand and kind of drape it over your body. if your left hand is draped over your body, bring it back to your mat. If not, just push into the palm of your left hand, sinking back onto your hips. As you lift your right arm up to the sky, and we're going to just rotate it. Nice big circles. Maybe pausing in any spots that feel a little sticky. Going the opposite direction. We'll bring our hands back down to our mats. Take a few cat-cows at your own pace. Notice if you are pushing or forcing your body into a movement or way that you think the position should look like, and send some love to yourself while you relax and ease off a little bit. Finding a gentle sway. This time, left arm comes up. And exhale, threading our hand through our arm. And if your hand was draped over your body, definitely do so on this side as well. Slowly bring your palm to your mat, pushing into your right hand, coming back to tabletop as we circle our left arm. And we'll go the opposite way. Coming onto our feet if this is comfortable. Otherwise, you can come into a cross-legged position. And we'll take our right arm and bend our elbow to touch our upper back. We can stay here if this is enough, or if you want to feel into your shoulder more, bending the left arm and see if you can allow your fingers to touch. And if they touch, maybe they're clasping and you can use this balance to allow your chest to open more. Gently release wherever you are, lifting your right hand up to the sky and just twinkling your fingers. Bring that hand down to your mat. This time, left arm comes up, bending at the elbow to gently press into the upper back. Breathe. And bring your right arm up if you did on the other side.
to your hands. Lift your left arm up to the ceiling and twinkle your fingers. Coming forward, bringing our knees back. We'll gently come into a child's pose just for a moment. And when you're ready, coming forward onto our bellies for our Sphinx. Bowing our toes, 2 points behind us. Our elbows are underneath our shoulders. And we're going to open up through the chest. Imagine our shoulders are spreading apart and we're grabbing into the mat to bring it closer to our heart. Slowly bring your chin into your chest, rounding your spine as you roll back into child's pose. As you roll back into puppy pose.
Slowly push into your hands, rolling forward onto your belly and flipping over onto your back. Windshield wiper your legs side to side. Let's bring our right foot up to the ceiling and rotate our ankle, crossing our ankle over our left thigh and reaching in between our legs to grab onto the back of our left thigh. Place your left foot on the ground. Shift your hips over to the right and allow your knees to gently fall to the left. Slowly bring your knees back up, uncross your legs, this time left foot comes up to the sky, rotating the ankle, crossing that ankle over the thigh of our right leg as we come into figure four. On your next breath, slowly lower your right leg onto your mat, shifting your hips over to the left side as your knees come down to the right. Thank you. inhale, bring your knees back up to your mat and take any last movements that your body might be craving before we go into our final resting posture of Shavasana. So when you're ready, extend your feet. Tuck your shoulders underneath the shoulder blades. Hands are either down or up. And we let go of the mind, let go of the body, let go of our practice. Slowly start deepening your breath. Wiggling your fingers and your toes. Rotating your wrists and your ankles. And when you're ready, go ahead and take a nice big stretch overhead. Then come on over to the right side of your body. Into a fetal position.
And when you're ready, using your hands to help you find your way back to a nice, comfortable, seated position. And we'll take a few neck rolls. Switching directions. We'll inhale our hands up to the sky, bringing all of this relaxing, grounding energy in towards our heart, showing ourselves compassion and love and grace. I thank you for sharing your practice with me today. I'm honored to be spending this time with you on our mats together, and wishing you a very happy new year. Namaste.